Let's have some tea time. I made some Genmai Cha tea, and it is delicious. Genmai Cha tea is a green tea with toasted brown rice. And I have like little bits, I don't know if you can see, but I have like little bits of brown rice floating on the top. Okay, so I wanted to do like a quick, like a haul video slash like favorites, because whenever I go shopping, like I don't buy like that many items. So the first item I wanted to shout out was this, it's a PJ set, and it's like a button down, and it has like a pocket on the side, and yeah, and it has sleeves that are like this short, and yeah, it's like really comfortable, and it has a matching pair of pants that are really short. I didn't realize how short it was until I got it for my mom. So we have like matching PJ sets, and yeah, like it looked really short on her. So, but it's really cute. Like this reminds you of Golden Girls, which I love Golden Girls. It's one of my favorite shows. And it kind of matches this mod a little bit, like I'm rocking the pink and blue and pink and tealish color look. So I have the fan on. I have the crackling candles on. I hope you can hear both. I really like those videos that have like the background noise, like it's kind of like when you go on a car ride, you know, it just makes you fall asleep really easily. Okay, so one thing that I bought kind of recently was a new phone, and I wouldn't say this is a favorite, but I do want to give like a quick like a review of this case, the OtterBox case. So I have the Pixel 6 phone, and I bought this case from OtterBox. I don't know if you can see, but it has like sparkles on it. It's like really sparkly, and I also bought this like pop socket. I've always been curious about pop sockets, but it's really convenient for me. Because I have kind of like small hands, so I'm not always like this, you know, like, I don't know, my hands started hurting, with my last phone, and yeah, the pop socket is really nice. The only downside to this is that I also bought a, wireless charger that works through this, this case, but there isn't enough like surface area to cover the wireless charger, so I had to choose either a pop socket or a wireless charger, and I decided to go with the pop socket, so I have to return the wireless charger. One thing I could have done is I could have like taken out my case every time I wanted to charge my phone at night, but I think that's a little too much work for me. Like, it's not easy to take off this case. And I haven't dropped my phone yet, so I don't know whether this case is invincible. And it wasn't that cheap either. It was like $50 for like this plastic thing. And I got this pop socket from Target for, it's like 17 or something, but yeah, it matches. It's like pink and blue, and it matches the case, it matches my personality, so I just wanted to go over this. One thing I got from TJ Maxx was these little, like, foam, organizers or like wire organizers. It comes in a pack of like 9 or 12, and I have it on like the side of my desk, and I have my phone charger like on the hook. The downside to this is that it's not as secure as it looks. Like, it can come out like pretty easily once you kind of like pull it, which can be a good and also a bad thing. I think I just want something more secure if I have to choose another one, but this is a good way to organize your wires, because my phone charger always goes on the floor, so I have to like pick it up every time. So that was a haul. Oh, another thing that I found at TJ Maxx that I think is a really good deal, and I know we're all looking for deals right now because everything is, you know, really expensive, is this Dickinson's Original Witch Hazel. And I got it for $3 at TJ Maxx, and there's a really good TJ Maxx near where I live. But I got this there because I usually get it at Target, and it's like almost $6. And so when I went to TJ Maxx, I saw one, and I was like, maybe I should get one, you know, just to try it out. You know, it's not, I use it so much, so might as well just try it out. And when I got home, I looked up, like, when does Witch Hazel expire? And I read that it doesn't expire, so after I read that, I was like, oh my gosh, I need to go to TJ Maxx and get, I got, like, 2 more Dickinsons. So, yeah, I mean, it's a pretty good deal. It's almost half off, if you think about it, like $6 versus $3. And when I went to the TJ Maxx, they had one with $3 and the other one didn't have a price tag, so the lady gave me both for $3 each. So that was really nice of her. Alright, so that's a secret, I guess. Don't tell anyone. Another thing that I love during the summertime is, I don't know whether you have to deal with like mosquitoes, but there's a lot of mosquitoes like in my backyard, and one thing I really recommend is this Tecnu anti-itch spray. It's a rash relief, and it's for outdoor itches, insect bites, and more. And trust me, this works amazingly. It's not that expensive, but it's not that cheap either. I got this from Walgreens for like $13 a while ago, so it's probably like $16 or even, I don't even know. Everything is going up nowadays. So yeah, if you're having like mosquito problems, I would highly recommend this Tecnu anti-itch spray. And I think I found it near the alcohol section of Walgreens, or the like foot care section. I don't know why it's near the foot care section, but I had a really hard time finding it at Walgreens. Okay. Another thing that I got from TJ Maxx, and I normally don't get skincare products, is this Sarwa Su clarifying mask, and it was actually a set of 2 masks. So this is the overnight vitalizing mask, and then this is the Sarwa Su clarifying mask. This one I tried yesterday. I didn't like the consistency of it. Like, it's like brown. And it smells like Suahuasu products. It's really thick, and I read online that it's a peel-off mask, but I just couldn't get a thick enough layer without using, like, this entire bottle. So I did, like, a thickish layer, but not thick enough so that I can, like, peel it off. So I just washed it off with water, and my skin looked really nice after using this product. You can see, like, I had this product all over my hands, and it just got really messy. So, gotta be a little careful when trying to use this product, and it's, like, really thick. Maybe I'll use that for, like, a good wind down with me or something video. And this is the overnight vitalizing mask, and it's really it's basically like a cream. I don't know if you can see. So yeah, it looks like this. So far, two products have like a warm ginseng. I don't know how to explain it other than it smells like ginseng. Yeah, it's kind of sharp. It has like a woody smell to it. I mean, it doesn't smell like flowery or anything like that. It has a more like musky scent to it. I mean, I love Suahuasu products. I know in like Korean culture or Korean community, like, it's for older people, so that means it has to be good, right? But I think it means, like, the price point is for, like, older people. I don't know. But I love Suahuasu products. I used to use their, like, skincare products, but it's just too expensive for me. And there are other products that are around my price range, and they're as good, you know? So, yeah. This tea is so delicious. I have two more items. So the next item that I got, it's not a favorite, but it's this car air vent mount, and I got this for $5 because I needed something to mount my phone, you know, when I'm driving. Yeah, I don't know, there needs to be a product that incorporates a case. This pop socket, a wireless charger, and something for the car, because we all know that people need something to put it on the car, or put their phone next to them in the car so that they can see the phone, which can be kind of dangerous, but it's actually really annoying when I can't see my phone. Like, I need to, like, look for my phone every time I need it. With my old phone. Alright, so I found my old phone that the screen broke. But I had, like, one of these things. This is a Pixel 4a. And my goodness, it is so light compared to the 6. Yeah, I really liked this phone. I really liked it because this little circle right here is a fingerprint detector. So when you're using your phone, it's like this. And this phone is actually, like, easy to hold. And I didn't have a case for it, so That's probably why it only lasted like 2 years. But I have one of these things and I just like clipped it onto the back of the car, and it was really convenient. But I mean, this magnet blends in with the back of my phone so easily. But with this one, it's either one of these like circles or these like the square thing. I mean, I can try it maybe. Let's try it together. You can either like, you can fit it between your phone and your phone case, which I don't know how I feel about that, because I had to wait over a week to get my pink Pixel Pro phone, so I really like to show off the pink color of my phone, so I don't want something that's like blocking the color, you know? It's just, I don't know, there needs to be a system. I guess I'm just rambling and complaining about phones. Oh, and while I was looking for my phone, I found the OtterBox cover case, I guess, where it comes in. It's the Otter Symmetry, and it's drop tested 3 times to military standards, and I don't know what that means. It has a lasting antimicrobial case protection, and it's made with more than 50% recycled plastic. It's 5G compatible material, and it's wireless charging compatible, which is why I bought the wireless charger. And unfortunately, I can't use the wireless charging because I have to choose. I chose the pop socket, and I could not find a pop socket brand with a cover for Pixel 6. Like, I've looked everywhere. So, for those who really like the Pixel series, I mean, I understand the struggle. And if there is a product out there that I don't know about, please let me know, because, yeah, I'm ready to make that purchase. Mm-hmm. By the way, when I have kids, I want to buy like the pajama set. You know what I mean? Like the family pajama set. I think that is like so, so cute. Like, I know some people think it's not that, I don't know, it's kind of lame, but I really love it. I mean, that's why I bought my mom the same one in size small for her. And it actually looked really good on her. Like, whenever we go shopping together, whatever looks good on her doesn't look good on me, and vice versa. So I thought, like, it might not look good on her, and she doesn't like really bright colors like this. But it actually looked really good on her. Maybe it doesn't look good on me, you know, because it looks good on her. I do have one last favorite item, and you know what it is? It's the M-lactin daily 12% lactic acid. I have a funny story, not funny, but like I have a story to tell you with this. I was at Costco, and I get the M-lactin from Costco because it's the best deal. And so I was at Costco, and I was like looking for the M-lactin. They didn't have it except for like the last two. But the top, you know, when you buy it, like the top is like down and you have to like twist it open. But when I went to Costco, the top was up like this. Excuse me. And you can tell that like some people used the lotion. And so, and I'm sure like some people have like used the lotion while like walking by or something. But I think it was like $16 originally, but it had like the $4 off sale going on. And then so my mom like talked to one of the customer service people, and he's like, can I give it to you for $10? I was like, sure. And so we got like two lotions for like $10 each. And I don't think like it was, I don't think many people used it, because I've gotten a lot of amlactins and they always kind of like, they fill it up to like here, you know? I don't know, they don't fill it up all the way. So I was happy with that purchase. That was like my bargain purchase that I was willing to make, because first of all, I really needed amlactin. Like, I was running low on amlactin, and every time I went to Costco, they didn't have amlactin, and I was like kind of like freaking out a little bit, because I was like, I need amlactin. And I didn't really want to buy it at like CVS, because it's like way overpriced there. So I was like, okay, if I can get it for like $10, that's way better deal than like $20 at CVS or something for like half the bottle, you know? Yeah. I still haven't really gotten into like the CVS, you know, the whole bucks thing, care bucks. I don't know what you call it, but you know, like on their long receipt, they have like on the bottom, like $2 off of your next purchase or something. I don't know. I just don't have the time and energy to get to do that, all that kind of stuff. I mean, if you're someone who is really good at that kind of stuff, then let me know your secrets, because I'm all about deals and stuff. Okay, so I think that's all I had. So yeah, the Dickinson's Original Witch Hazel that you can get at TJ Maxx for like half off. You can get this little cord organizer. I don't know whether I'm going to open this or not. I don't know. We'll see. And yeah, this Tecnu Rash Relief Anti-Itch Spray. It's amazing. Trust me. And mosquito bites are awful, because like when I'm sleeping, I can't like sleep at night, because I'm always like scratching my legs, you know? And this will stop it in one or two like sprays. It smells, it has like a pos smell to it. You know what I mean? Like kind of like a fresh scent, like vapor rub, you know, that kind of smell to it. So it's not too bad. Oh, I wanted to tell you, if you have a mosquito problem at home, what I do is I have like a spray bottle, and I fill it up with isopropyl alcohol, which you can also get at like CVS or Walgreens, and I fill it up, and then I just like wait until the mosquito is like close to my legs, and they always fly low, and then I spray them. And something about the alcohol, like it's like really heavy or something, it like makes the mosquito like not able to fly anymore, so the mosquito drops on the floor, and then I like wipe it up with a towel or a tissue or something. So that's how I hunt for mosquitoes, and that's like one of my joys. Although it's really annoying when you have to do something and like there's a mosquito in the living room and you can't leave the living room, because if you leave, then you're not going to be able to find the mosquito again. Anyway, alright, thank you for listening, and if you are listening, listening all the way until now, then I congratulate you for lasting this long and sticking with me. Alright, I hope you enjoyed our tea time, and I hope you enjoyed a random hodgepodge of favorites and hauls. Alright, I'll talk to you next time. Bye!